And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the latest addition to the PlayStation family. Thank you. Why is PlayStation Portable so important at this stage in the game? After building tremendous equity in the home console space, we began to look at the mobile market. We waited to introduce a product at the right time, and we believe the timing now is right. The proliferation of mobile devices is at an all-time high. And in fact, many of us carry around more than one device. Today, the worldwide market for mobile devices, whether it be cell phones, digital music devices, productivity tools, and gaming machines, is more than 1.4 billion units worldwide. PlayStation Portable will enter an already crowded space, but one with much growth opportunities. So, what is PlayStation Portable? It is a handheld video game system that offers 3D CG games incorporating high-quality, full-motion video similar to PlayStation 2. PlayStation Portable is as revolutionary as PlayStation, but in different ways. And PlayStation Portable is a brand new format and a brand new business for us. It is a totally new play experience. It incorporates new technologies like curved surfaces and wireless connectivity. It requires new titles design methodologies. It will entice new consumers, perhaps some new to gaming. And it will present new opportunities. PlayStation Portable will allow consumers to enjoy 3D gaming similar to the experience delivered on PlayStation 2. It also has the ability to deliver high-quality movies, music, and video, as well as other forms of digital entertainment content through one central device. It is based on a new optical disc medium developed by Sony called Universal Media Disc, or UMD. It incorporates wireless technology that will allow for new types of consumer interaction while gaming, as well as a multitude of opportunities for downloadable entertainment content, a first in this industry. And all of this is made possible through cutting-edge technologies aimed at helping us explore the future in new ways. The initial target audience for PSP is more reminiscent of our approach in the home console space. We will be looking at a primary target of 18 to 34-year-old males, and those users more apt to embrace new technologies and products early on. This group is one of the largest on PlayStation 2, and we know that they buy more games with more disposable income. The secondary target is the teen market, and this audience is bigger, more diverse, and more complex than ever before. PlayStation Portable is designed to take entertainment on the go. As you can see, it is black with the majority of the real estate taken up by a beautiful LCD display. The product dimensions are 170 millimeters long, 74 millimeters high, and 23 millimeters deep. In total, it weighs 260 grams. And as I mentioned, the screen is one of the product's key features, and it is very different from what is currently on the market. It is 4.3 inch wide TFT LCD widescreen. The aspect ratio is 16:9. This enhances the in-game peripheral vision and enables the same kind of situational awareness one would have on a high-resolution display. One area of some discussion has been the amount of onboard memory, so I am pleased to announce that PlayStation Portable will have 32 megabytes of main memory and 4 megabytes of embedded DRAM. PlayStation Portable has built-in stereo speakers. It includes onboard ports for headphones, microphone, controllers, power, and battery recharge. UMD is a delivery medium, and we will accommodate both regional and parental access controls. So here's a look at PlayStation Portable's main input-output areas. First is the wireless port. We plan to support the IEEE 802.11b standard for wireless local area network usage. 802.11b is one of the most efficient ways to connect wireless devices, including the PC, to the internet, and to each other at a very high speed. And it will have profound implications for a world bent on anytime, anywhere communication. We plan to support USB 2.0 and Memory Stick Duo Pro, which will make it easy for consumers to upload and download content between each other and devices between, for example, the PC. PlayStation Portable will have an IRDA or infrared data port and an IR remote using Sony's CIRC standards. Battery and battery life are key aspects for portable gaming. PlayStation Portable will have a lithium-ion battery. Made of lithium, lithium-ion batteries are much lighter and ideal for mobile devices. They have the longest operating life without having to be recharged. So what is the battery life going to be on PlayStation Portable? It will be on par with traditional handheld systems, or approximately 10 hours. It is comparable to an HDD-based portable music player, or approximately 8 hours. Or it'll be comparable to portable DVD players, which in many cases is about 2.5 hours. We are planning for a wide range of peripherals for PlayStation Portable. Some you may expect, and other non-conventional items. Some of the standard peripheral plans include a stand, remote controller, headphones, battery pack, carrying case, and of course a strap. Other new items that will be a first on PlayStation Portable are a USB camera, GPS systems, and a keypad, all custom designed for the product. UMD is set to become a new global format, one that can be used in many future products, including PlayStation Portable. UMD is a large capacity optical disc medium specifically designed by Sony with PlayStation Portable in mind. And in fact, its storage capacity is 3 times that of a CD-ROM. This format is the perfect solution to delivering high-quality CD games, movies, music, and many other forms of digital entertainment. It will come with lower manufacturing costs, which will ultimately minimize inventory risk and allow for a more progressive business model. And as with any initiative from Sony Computer Entertainment, games, great games, are viewed as the most important application. This is how we view PlayStation Portable for the very best games, now portable play on the go. The difference that PlayStation Portable makes is now that we have the ability to bring modern 3D console experience to a mobile platform. We're very excited about this opportunity, and this enthusiasm is shared by many in the industry. It was important to make PlayStation Portable very easy to develop for, to encourage the types of support that consumers have come to expect with PlayStation products. The development environment is based on OpenGL-like graphics API and a robust compiler. In the past, we've seen new systems with greater power, but at the price of higher development costs. The opposite is happening with PlayStation Portable. The power and ease of development puts developers in this incredible sweet spot because they are going to be able to deliver true console-like experiences without high-end console development expenses. And because of this, we are seeing a lot of variation in PlayStation Portable games even now. The key product drivers rest in four areas. First is the development of original intellectual properties. Second is the extension of existing PlayStation franchises, reborn in new and in different ways. The third is the ability to leverage the equity built into PlayStation 2 products for interoperability between our home console and PlayStation Portable. And finally, not to be undervalued, is the advent of wireless gaming and all of the possibilities that this may bring to the market. We view our world as one with a connected future. This includes the ability to connect PlayStation Portable to many other platform devices like PlayStation 2, other PSP units, and the PC. These abilities offer some really exciting possibilities for games and the gaming market. As with our home consoles, we're fortunate to have support from all of the best companies in the business on PlayStation Portable. This includes 34 companies from Japan, like Konami, Capcom, Namco, and Bandai. 24 companies from North America, like Electronic Arts, Activision, THQ, and Take-Two. 31 companies from Europe, like Ubisoft, Atari, and Codemasters. 10 companies from South Korea, like Axis Entertainment and Nexon. And of course, from all of the Sony Computer Entertainment development studios worldwide. So, let's take a look at some of the fruits of their labor. We're gonna switch and flip till we get the hits. Gotta make you move your hips. In line with the funky rhyme, and the people say we're gonna lose our mind. What? Thank you. And now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce a man and a business partner from one of the industry's most prominent publishers who has joined us on stage on several occasions in the past. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to the president of Electronic Arts Worldwide Studios, Don Mattrick.
Thank you, Kaz. Good morning, everyone. Since the launch of the PlayStation 1, SCEA and Electronic Arts have formed one of the most powerful partnerships in the entertainment industry. When PlayStation 2 launched in 2000, EA supported it with six games, including Madden NFL and SSX. By the end of that first year, we had a 40% market share, and we never looked back. We consider that achievement to be the reflection on our commitment to Sony. PlayStation 2 showed us how important great content is to the launch of any new hardware. And Sony has always understood it's all about great software. When PlayStation Portable debuts next year, EA will provide the same degree of support that we gave the PlayStation 2. We've committed the resources and the people to make the PlayStation Portable a huge success. Right now, more than 100 of EA's best engineers, designers, and artists are doing early work for this system. When PlayStation Portable debuts next spring, EA will have a minimum of 4 titles supporting the launch. These titles include NBA Street, NFL Street, Tiger Woods PGA Tour Golf, and Need for Speed Underground. Everyone at EA is excited about the look and feel of these games. I want to show you some footage that captures early code run on a PC architecture. The emulator we're using is based on early specifications that Sony released in their public statements about the PlayStation Portable. I think you're going to be impressed. The super sharp graphics and 16:9 aspect ratio give these games a look that I think will soon be identified with the PlayStation Portable. Let's take a look. Before I leave, I want to thank Kaz, Kutaragi-san, and all the people at Sony Computer Entertainment. Every year, you make gaming more fun.
Thank you, Don. Thank you. Mr. Don Mattrick. A special thanks to Don for joining us here today. And we look forward to hearing and seeing all of EA's titles on PlayStation Portable in the very near future. As I mentioned, UMD is a really unique format specifically designed to accommodate digital entertainment needs through PlayStation Portable. We view games as the killer application for this product. But part of the process of establishing a new global format is encouraging support from a variety of entertainment partners. The gaming companies have definitely showed us the way by their overwhelming support for PlayStation Portable. But we have also received interest from other major entertainment partners outside of games that see the overall market potential. This support includes movie studios and music labels. Part of the attraction is their confidence in our ability to make PlayStation Portable a success to the level that we have done with our home consoles. And we have guaranteed an open profile policy and licensee model to encourage their support. And now we would like to show you demonstrations of UMD content from some of our content partners. The first demo comes from our sister company, Sony Pictures Entertainment. You might have heard that they're planning to release a new Spider-Man feature film next month. Here is one of their latest movie trailers for Spider-Man 2 running on PlayStation Portable.
I believe there's a hero in all of us. Gives us strength, makes us noble. Even though sometimes we have to give up the thing we want the most.
Parker!
Where you been? Looking for you all morning?
You're late.
Always late!
You're fired!
Look at you, Peter. Your grades have been declining. You always appear exhausted.
I know, I'm trying.
So where you been, pal? You don't return my calls.
I've been kind of busy.
Taking pictures of your friend.
Spider-Man killed my father.
No matter what I do,
do you love me or not?
No matter how hard I try,
I want Spider-Man dead.
It's the ones I love who will always be the ones who pay.
I can't keep thinking about you. I'm getting married.
I want a life of my own. I'm Spider-Man. No more.
You look different.
I let things get in the way before. There was something I thought I had to do. I don't have to.
I liked seeing you tonight, Peter.
Now on to the main event.
Octavius is gonna put Oscorp on the map in a way my father never even dreamed of.
Crazy scientist turns himself into some kind of a monster. Four mechanical arms welded right onto his body.
Who takes Spider-Man's pictures? Where is he?
You're taking me off your loyalty to Spider-Man and not to your best friend. Bring Spider-Man to me.
How do I find him?
Peter Parker.
Find Spider-Man, or I'll peel the flesh off her bones.
There are bigger things happening here than me and you.
Continues June 30th.
Spider-Man 2, ladies and gentlemen. The next UMD video demo comes from our long-standing partner, Square Enix. Yesterday, Square Enix announced an exciting new development in the world's most powerful franchise, Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy Advent Children is a fully developed visual entertainment sequel to Final Fantasy VII, the seminal 1997 PlayStation hit. Through more than 70 minutes of beautifully crafted content, Final Fantasy Advent Children revisits the universe of memorable characters of Final Fantasy VII 2 years after its dramatic conclusion. Square Enix announced that Final Fantasy Advent Children is coming to DVD, and now we're pleased to have this as part of our UMD video family. So, let's take a sneak peek at Final Fantasy Advent Children.
The planet weaves a cruel fate for men. Children are always the first to suffer. Geostigma. Genova. Reunion. Children who have lost hope. Respite for the soul. And so he takes sword in hand once again. C7, Advent Children.
I'd like to thank Square Enix for providing us with this content to share with you all this morning. The UMD format also offers some exciting and interesting possibilities for the music industry. In addition to digital music distribution, UMD will allow artists to package and distribute all types of content, fusion of music and video through PlayStation Portable. The next demo was provided by Sony Music Entertainment. It is a video from one of the hottest alternative bands in the market today, Incubus. They just released a new album, so let's take a look at one of Incubus's latest videos running on PlayStation Portable. Incubus, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, the possibilities are endless. In addition to packaged media, we're also considering extending Sony Kinect's digital music service to PlayStation Portable users. Launched last week, Sony Kinect will be first available on PlayStation Portable in the United States. Please allow me to extend a special word of thanks to Sony Pictures Entertainment, Square Enix, Sony Music Entertainment, and Incubus for those great demonstrations. The PlayStation Portable release schedule breaks out as follows. Calendar end 2004 target in Japan. Fiscal end release for North America and Europe, or by the end of March 2005, with Korea and other markets thereafter. And we're on track to ship approximately 3 million units of PlayStation Portable by the end of our fiscal year.